Miss Havisham and Estella are two wastes of human beings. Miss Havisham has spent her whole life feeling sorry for herself, and Estella has spent her whole life listening to the miserable woman. Estella is such a puppet. Literally. I think I saw Miss Havisham's hand up her butt. I'm glad Estella started thinking for herself a bit, but she's still a loser. I don't see why Pip in his younger years kept going back. I mean, I don't think anybody's worth that much suffering. I don't think he did it just for Estella. I think he did it out of fear of Miss Havisham. He was afraid to say no because she was so wealthy and powerful. Wasn't Pip's reason at all. Maybe Pip's reason was because Miss Havisham keeps a loaded gun under her shawl. She deserved, though. Hey, it's Steven Seagal. We'll be back right after this brief message.
Communication systems were the same.
I tried to save the company a few bucks. It took 2 days to download specs from Cleveland. Lost the account.
Much is known about Estella's mother. She was Jagger's servant and also a murdering gypsy. Wow, that's cool. She seemed like a loser to us. We just put her in because she had gross wrists. Are in agreement that Biddy who was Pip's teacher, friend, and very nearly his wife, was the only significant female character in the entire story that wasn't a failure. She was nice to Pip when others were cruel. She listened when he had something to say, and she taught him when he was ignorant. Even after all that, Pip didn't even have the guts to stick up for her when Orlick danced at her. Pip was a loser for not asking her to marry him sooner. Purposes, we decided to put part of Mrs. Joe's sketch at the end. Pretty clever, eh? Well, you know the saying, what goes around comes around. Well, it sure did come around for that stupid butch Mrs. Joe. She wasn't so tough after Orlick beat the snot out of her, but it's kind of late to repent for a lifetime of cruelty when you're dying. This book in this day and age, women's lib would have him strung up on a flagpole by his